So recently, while doing some larger file transfers in my home network on my iPhone and iPad, I noticed that their throughput speeds were not as fast as their tech specs would imply that they should be. So that got me wondering if the limitation was on the client side or something on my access points. So currently I have the Ubiquiti UAP-AC-Pro. It's rated at 450 megabits per second on 2.4 gigahertz and 1300 megabits per second on the 5 gigahertz rate, and it can support up to 200 users. Now, what got me looking at the UAP-AC-HD was that the 2.4 gigahertz rate doubles almost to 800 megabits per second. And I feel that's important in my situation because oftentimes when walking around the house, the Apple products will switch over to the 2.4 gigahertz network because it might have the stronger signal. In my house, you almost have to be in the same line of sight of the access point to get that 5 gigahertz band. So again, looking at the HD access point, it goes up to 800 megabits per second, so we're almost doubling that 2.4 gigahertz rate. We increase the 5 gigahertz rate by 433 megabits per second, so what, that's like a 30% increase. So it's worth giving a shot. The only thing holding me back to this point was that it, you know, it seems kind of overkill. It supports 500 users here, but today I'm willing to give it a shot. So before we go changing anything, we need to get our before speed, so I'm going to use a tool called Iperf 3. And what that does is it basically opens up a local speed test server on a wired computer on your network. So here I am on a Windows desktop that is physically wired onto the network. And you just run the iperf command with a dash S to designate server. So this opens up a server on port 5201. So this will eliminate all other variables and just allow you to test the connections within your network, which is what I'm after. So now to make the client-side connection, you get the iperf app off the App Store and download it onto your phone. And it asks you for the server address, which is the computer you're running the iperf server on, and the server port. And then you can choose the transmit mode, upload or download, how many streams to use, and how long to run the test for. So I'm just going to go ahead and start that. And you can see the data transfers kicking off. So as you can see on the client-side readout, it's not going as high as one would expect, given the technical specs of an iPhone. And yes, I've made sure that my internal network is properly doing gigabit connections. When I run iperf between two wired computers, I get well over 900 megabits per second, so that's not the issue here. So now I'm curious to see if the Ubiquiti HD access point will give me higher speeds on my iPhone and iPad. So now let's quickly unbox the Ubiquiti HD access point, install it on the network, and rerun the speed test and see where we land. So in the box for the UAP-AC-HD, we have our access point and mounting plate with ring. Inside here we have the hardware for mounting and the PoE adapter, which we'll need later, and the power cord for the PoE adapter. So we moved to the living room of my house. This is where the majority of my high-speed Wi-Fi devices connect from. So this is where I'm going to make the investment to upgrade my existing UAP-AC-Pro. Side by side here, you can see both access points are very similar. The UAP-AC-HD is a little bit taller and wider, as you can see. They both use the same mounting ring. So if you're upgrading from a UAP-AC-Pro, you shouldn't have any issues using the existing mounting plate. What I wasn't aware of ahead of time was that the HD version cannot be powered by the Unifi US8 60 watt switch that I was using to power the Pro version with, but fortunately the HD version does come with a PoE injector, so that's not the end of the world. So now I'll just unplug the UAP-AC Pro from the network and replace that with the HD version. All right, so now that we've swapped out the Unifi AP Pro with the HD version, we can head inside the Unifi controller and adopt the new Wi-Fi access point. So the Unifi controller is telling us here at the top that our setup needs attention because we've disconnected one of the access points. So let's click into access points here. And it shows that our new Unifi AP-HD is pending adoption and that my old living room AP-AC Pro is disconnected. So the first thing I'll do is upgrade it. So in real time, that felt like forever, but we're back now, pending adoption. So we'll click into that and click on adopt. And now it's entered the provisioning state. All right, so that was pretty easy. The Unifi AP-HD is now online. Green bar means good. So now let's head into the device configuration and give it a new alias. I'll name this similarly to the one I'm replacing. So I'll call this living room AP-AC-HD. And to keep things organized on my network, I give all of my Unifi devices static IP addresses. So to do that, let's head over to the Unifi controller and head under network, change using DHCP to static IP. I'm going to change the dynamic IP that was assigned to the 192.168.1.9 address. I'm going to tell it to use the USG as my preferred DNS server. Leave it on the 255.255.255.0 subnet mask. For an alternate DNS, I'm going to use the 8.8.8.8, which I believe is Google's. And I will use the USG as my gateway. I'll just go ahead and queue those changes up. Might as well apply them now. So now we're back to provisioning. All right, now that we have the Unifi HD access point adopted onto the network and provisioned, we can head back into the Iperf terminal here and launch our speed test. And that's crazy, I'm not seeing much of a difference here. So if you have any ideas on why that might be, please leave me a comment down below and give me some pointers on that. So given the results we're seeing here, it seems like the limitation is on the client side, my iPhones and iPads. So if you were curious and in a similar situation as me, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please click on the like button down below and consider subscribing to my channel for more great tech reviews. Thanks for watching.